Those eight guys must have been pretty busy, right?
No, okay, first off, if there's a 6,000 years old, it fits perfectly with 6 billion people.
It doesn't fit perfectly.
Yeah, because about 150 years, the population doubles, and if you keep that average
the population
pace...
doesn't consistently, reliably double every 150
okay,
years.
Yeah.
What happens is that people survive at variable rates. Sometimes the population is flat because there's a lot of people dying off.
Okay, was it flat for 3 million years?
Yes.
Evolution?
Actually, the rate of population growth...
On an exponential scale,
yeah,
yes.
The rate of population growth was very, very small.
I can't read that, Mark.
For
sorry.
A long period of time. So...
Oh, if you want to believe 3 million years, be my guess, but
then,
I don't think that's very...
And let's be clear, it's not evolution that claims the Earth is 4.5 billion years, roughly...
That's fine, but...
It's actually geology.
Geology, well, if you don't want to believe in the geologic column, I mean, that's not reliable at all.
Yeah, actually it is.
You believe that... So you believe that those layers grew over millions of years?
No, they didn't grow over millions of years.
They added, the sediment added over millions of years.
I believe what the geologists claim happened.
Is that what
okay.
you... Well, that
so what you're telling us is that the Bible is reliable as long as we're willing to dismiss all of science in order to get there.
Yeah.
No, I'm just saying...
I mean, you don't seem to be particularly interested in what... I mean, what you're basically saying is what one person says is pretty much as good as what another person says. It doesn't matter how much study they've done. It doesn't matter how much the base science supports them. If it disagrees with the Bible, then it's got to be wrong by default.
I think if you show that the Earth... is 6,000 years old, like the Bible would indicate, I think that show that it's accurate.
Okay, good luck with that.
Yeah,
well,
good luck.
I have more claims.
All right.
Well, go ahead.
Okay.
Next.
The universe. The galaxies have their spiral shape. Can we agree on that?
Hang on,
I got galaxy
spiral right here. That's CE380.
And if the universe is over 10,000 years old, they wouldn't have those spiral tails. Because
spiral arms are density waves, which, like sound and air, travel through the galaxy's disk, causing a piling up of stars and gas at the crest of the waves. In some galaxies, the central bulge reflects the wave, giving rise to a giant standing spiral wave with a uniform rotation and a lifetime of about 1 or 2 billion years. The causes of the density waves are still not known, but there are many possibilities. Tidal effects from a neighboring galaxy probably cause some of them. The spiral pattern is energetically favorable. Spiral configurations develop spontaneously in computer simulations based on gravitational dynamics.
Okay.
I mean, this stuff you're saying is not, like, news to scientists in general. These aren't things that a bunch of, you know, that a bunch of biblical scholars came up with and completely
stumped
people.
You act like there's only scientists that... The scientists that we have now, none of them are Christians.
None of them are Christians.
Some of them are Christians, and they disagree with what you say.
Right. I mean, the Christians that study this stuff in depth generally don't stay like young Earth creationists. Some of them are old Earth creationists, but I mean, there is no real scientific support for the idea that the Earth is young. I mean,
yeah.
No.
No, there actually isn't.
Really.
Okay, you know, you're familiar with carbon dating at all?
Yes, we are.
Yes.
Okay. It
and
can only be measured up to,
accurate
about...
to a limited amount of time in the past, yes. There are other methods of radiometric dating that are accurate to longer periods.
But in the lowest layers of the geologic column, why can we still date it at carbon dating, period?
Because that's a misapplication. People are taking things which are older than carbon dating is good for and misapplying it and coming up with the numbers that they see and pretending that this is a big disaster for science.
You don't understand. If you can still measure carbon in it, then that means that it's less than millions of years old. It can only be maximum 80,000.
There's this thing called a half-life. The carbon never completely disappears.
But they can't measure it after four or five half-lives.
You understand that there's different forms of carbon, right?
Yeah, I mean, there's... I mean, I know they date things, potassium argon, radiometric, etc.,
okay.
but none of those work either.
Yeah, they actually do. And you know the cool thing about these things is that when you start dating things with the appropriate radiometric tool, they all converge on the same answer. And when you have multiple lines of evidence converging on the same answer, then proposing another absurdly out-of-range answer is just ridiculous.
Absurdly out-of-range answer?
Yeah, like 6,000 years.
Okay, here's some dates for radiometric.
Okay.
Let's see. This is Mount Etna. The rock they used is basalt. They note the date known was 21,000 years. It measured 25 million. I wouldn't say that's accurate.
Well, where are you getting this?
That you could use that as a source right there, but
I'm sorry.
No.
Where are you
Mount
getting
what?
Mount Etna?
Can you spell that?
Mount Etna.
Can you spell that?
Etna. Mount Etna.
Okay.
Okay. What about it?
The date they've measured with radiometric dating on basalt rock.
Who did the measurement?
What's that?
Who did the measurement?
I just have the dates. I could find that, but I don't have it on me right now.
Okay. So
it was
so
measured.
Who's reporting this?
I'm sure I can tell you that, but I'm sure if you look that up, that's there, because that's the source. But I got that from John Morris.
Okay.
He's a creationist.
Who's a young Earth creationist, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and if you want, I have a few more.
Well, I mean, why would we be interested in rehashing creationist claims over and over again?
So why would you believe that dating if it's off by 25 million years? Why would you believe it?
The question is, you've got creationists who are going out and using inappropriate dating techniques.
Whoa! How can you assume it's inappropriate?
Where are the published papers, the mainstream peer-reviewed scientific papers that this is a serious flaw in the in the radiometric dating?
Well, you can check him up. He cites everything he shows.
Yeah, he says things, but there's a difference. I'm sorry.
No,
I'm stepping on you.
No, John Morris. I mean, he's been exposed as a guy who really doesn't know what he's talking about when it comes to radiometric dating. He makes a lot of claims. He can't back it up. He doesn't have the credentials. If he had the credentials, he'd be published in mainstream publications. And believe me, if he found a flaw in radiometric dating that caused
Okay. If he found
a flaw in radiometric dating that was this significant, he would be famous for it.
And not among creationist circles.
Exactly.
I mean, actually, among scientists.
So my question is, why are you citing a guy who does not have the credentials to actually be regarded as any kind of authority in this area?
But that doesn't mean those dates are wrong.
Yeah, actually, it
does. Have a credential. It does. You can prove that those dates are wrong.
No. It's not because he lacks his credentials. It's because he's wrong.
You know that date off the top of your head?
Do I know what off the top of my head?
It comes back full circle to the first thing you asked, which is why not believe in a God? And I said the default is to be skeptical of stuff until there's evidence provided that a thing is true. If we got some guy off the street who says that my primary goal is to advance biblical truth, and then he makes a bunch of claims which run counter to the prevailing science, I don't have the information right now to say whether he's wrong. I'm just saying that the burden of proof is on his side.
Okay,
he needs to bring the evidence and get it peer reviewed so that people who are qualified, which is not like you, me, and Jen, but people who actually are able to evaluate the scientific evidence with a background in studying this stuff, can accept or reject it. And the fact that it's not in peer reviewed scientific journals is a major issue that means that we don't have to bother worrying about it that much.
Still, dating or not, it doesn't matter, because when God made everything, He made it with age.
How do you know?
Okay, take Adam and Eve.
Yeah.
When He made them, they weren't babies, were they?
You know,
they
I don't believe that Adam and Eve exist, right?
Well, just can you hear my point out for a second?
No, you're saying that this is something that could have happened. I understand the Adam and Eve argument. I'm saying, how do you know it did happen that way?
Well, I believe the biblical creation.
All right, so in the end, we're not talking about arguments that prove that God exists. We're not talking about evidence. We're talking about accepting your beliefs as they are.
No, okay, here's my number one evidence that God exists.
Okay.
I believe that... And I can give
and
you...
this is going to have to be the last one, because we got to move on to other callers.
Okay, but I believe that the universe is so accurately designed, you can't deny a creator.
We've already been over
that
one.
Well, yeah, we just talked about that.
Okay, thanks for calling.